Finally tonight, the 6 Oscar nominations and a long list of movie credits. Whatever measure you use, Australian film director Peter Weir has had an outstanding career. Remember Gallipoli and one of my favourites, The Year of Living Dangerously, celluloid classics. Well, Peter's new film is his first in 7 years, the aptly named The Way Back. Danny Isdale sat down recently with Peter Weir to chat about his long sabbatical and his return to the big screen.
Kindness can kill you here.
You've made some amazing films. How do you rank this one? Would you say, it's probably like choosing between children, but would you say this is your best work so far?
Well, no, I mean, I hope it's as good as anything I've done. I've put as much into it as I, you know, have with others. It's finally the audience that makes the choice in a way. But I gave it the best I could.
If you are serious about making a run for it, hey, I'm with you.
Yeah, I love a bit of freedom on the day, but this was very tightly scheduled. You know, we had, you know, 3 countries to cover. We had a large cast who were always on camera. And we had some rough country to go through.
Did Peter work you to the bone? Sounds like a pretty grueling shoot.
No, he worked himself to the bone. He worked us, we all worked hard. Peter leads very much and directs very much by example, I found.
Someone's been following us.
No!
She needs protection.
We can barely feed ourselves.
She comes with us.
They'll kill us all.
We're already dying.
I remember watching Gallipoli when I was really young, like with my dad. I remember my dad watched some of his films. And then when my dad found out I was going to be working with him, he said, oh, ask him questions about Picnic and Hanging Rock. Ask him what was really up there.
He's really not just a director. He gets involved in everything, set, design, costume. He's very involved and very supportive of his actors. And he's just a really lovely man to be around. He's very inspirational and just lovely to listen to.
But he has an instinct and a feeling and an intelligent design of where this thing is headed. And I would work with him immediately.
Go over the Himalayas?
How?
We walk.
Peter, you choose your project so carefully. Why did you choose this story to tell?
Well, the same reason I've chosen any of them, I think. It's when I can't get it off my mind. It's almost as if, in a way, I'll say no to almost everything, you know, and if it comes in back in my sleep or on a drive to the city, or if I can't get it off my mind, I think, well, here you are. The only way to get rid of you is to make you into a film. So if I have said no, I'll ring the agent up and say, I hope you didn't actually really call them and say no, because I want to do it.
Is there anything haunting you at the moment then?
There is, yeah. There is something. Can you feel it? Can you feel it? Yeah, I've got one of that little nagging thing, but I think I want to make sure it's right.
Will we have to wait 7 years again this time?
I don't think it's a good idea. Not getting any younger. I'd like to, you know, get to work in the next couple of years. If it makes sense.
Can you feel it? That's it from us for now. After the stuff on all of our minds this week, dare I mention an M-word? No, not multiculturalism, not Muslim, definitely not Morrison, but Monday. See you then.